How do many kinds of cells arise from a single cell during development? Single-cell sequencing technologies and new computational tools are providing the most detailed picture yet of this process. In several types of studies, embryos of different stages were separated into individual cells, and the cells are sequestered away in droplets of oil. What kind of cell am I looking at here? To find out, the researchers sequenced each cell's messenger RNA, which reflects active genes. Each cell type has a profile, a set of active genes that define its identity as a muscle cell or a type of brain cell. How do I track a cell through time? In one line of experiments, researchers analyzed some 92,000 zebrafish cells and gathered data from 7 different embryo stages. To help tie the cells to a time point, they added genetic barcode DNA to the cytoplasm of some of the single-cell embryos. These are many tiny pieces of unique DNA that will be incorporated over time into the genomes of daughter cells. By the end of the experiment, the combinations of barcodes reveal how the cells are related. Thus, they could trace each zebrafish cell's fate through time to see how a single cell gave rise to a variety of specialized cells, such as heart, nerves, and skin. What can this tell us? This approach is already yielding results. Developmental biologists have thought that once the cell starts down a path to become, say, a muscle cell, that it would not stray. But researchers observed some zebrafish cells switch to different new types, as indicated by the change in what genes were active, after they should have been well committed to a certain fate. In frogs, gene activity showed that even when an embryo looks like an undifferentiated blob, cells are already starting down the paths to their eventual identities. With these tools, researchers can also see how development differs from one animal to the next, or even learn a recipe for coaxing different cell types from stem cells.